Hello everyone. Today we are going to step through the evolution of 802.11 wireless standards. This is one of the most famous wireless technologies in the world. Almost all our devices rely on this technology. There are many different types of Wi-Fi standards. Router, laptop, tablet, mobile and smart home devices all use different wireless standards to connect to the internet. Wireless standards are a set of services and protocols that determine how a Wi-Fi network operates. The most common set of wireless standards is the IEEE 802.11. Its different versions came during the different years. Let's see some of the important features of each version briefly. 802.11 is a base version created in 1997. It provided a speed up to 2 megabits per second. And the frequency was 2.4 GHz band. It used a modulation method of frequency hopping spread spectrum and direct sequence spread spectrum. 802.11b, new name Wi-Fi 1. It was created in 1999. This standard achieved a maximum speed of 11 megabits per second and used a typical frequency 2.4 GHz band. Modulation method it used was DSSS and CCK. 802.11b was the standard that kick-started Wi-Fi's popularity. 802.11a is an extension of 802.11b. It was also created in the same year, 1999, that provided speed up to 54 megabits per second in 5 GHz band. It used OFDM modulation scheme. 5 GHz frequency had more difficulty with objects that were in the signal's path, so the range was often poor. 11A came after 11B because of OFDM technology. 802.11G. It was designed in 2003. 802.11G standard upgraded the speed up to 54 megabits per second, while retaining usage of the reliable 2.4 GHz band. This resulted in the widespread adoption of the standard. It was also based on OFDM. 802.11n. It was introduced in 2009. This version had slow initial adoption. 802.11n supported multi-channel usage. Each channel offered a maximum data rate up to 600 megabits per second. It operated on both frequencies, 2.4 and 5 GHz. It used new technology for modulation, multiple input, multiple output, along with OFDM. 802.11ac. It was initially released in 2014. 802.11ac significantly increased the data throughput for Wi-Fi devices up to a maximum of 3.5 gigabits per second. 802.11ac added additional Wi-Fi broadcast channels for 5 GHz frequency band and support for more antennas on a single router. It used more advanced technology, beamforming, for directing signals toward a specific receiving device. Another significant advancement with 802.11ac was multi-user MIMO. While MIMO directs multiple streams to a single client, multi-user MIMO can direct the multiple streams to multiple devices simultaneously. While multi-user MIMO doesn't increase the speed of any single client, it can increase the overall data throughput of the entire network. Most home wireless routers are compliant with this standard. 802.11ax, also known as High Frequency Wireless LAN. It improved the performance of wireless LAN in dense scenarios such as sports, stadiums, and airports. It was released in late 2019 and throughout 2020. It provided speed up to 9.6 gigabits per second in both frequencies, 2.4 and 5 GHz band. It was based on OFDMA, orthogonal frequency division multiple access, and 1024 quadrature amplitude modulation, which increased overall throughput and bandwidth. It's been used in iPhone 12. It offered an increased in multi-user MIMO from 4x4 to 8x8. It allowed to connect even more devices in your home. Overall, it provided better and faster performance. Wi-Fi 6E is an extended version of Wi-Fi 6. It is based on Wi-Fi 6 and 5G networks. Technically, it has the same speed as Wi-Fi 6, but with Wi-Fi 6E, there will be 4 times more bandwidth. Ultimately, the user will get a higher speed. It released in the current year, 2021. It uses 1200 MHz spectrum in 6 GHz band. Old technologies were using 400 MHz spectrum. It will automatically switch over to 5 and 2.4 GHz for long range. Difference between 2.4 and 6 GHz is 2.4 GHz travels farther, but 6 GHz delivers data faster. In this version, there is less signal interference. It's been used in Samsung Galaxy S21. Wi-Fi 7 is also on the way and will be rolled out in 2024. Alright, so this wraps up today's video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.